Hello and welcome, I'm your Code Monkey, and in this video I'm going to give you 5 questions that you can ask yourself to decide what game to make. Let's begin! Question number 1. Is it a game you want to make? Some people might think of choosing what game to make based on what's popular and trying to chase that trend. If you do that, you really need to ask yourself if this is truly a game you want to make. Ask yourself if you're a fan of the genre and if you're excited to play the final version that you can see in your head. Making a game is a marathon and requires many hours to produce a compelling experience. It will be very difficult to force yourself to work on a game you have no passion for just because you think it won't be popular in the end. Every game obviously has roadblocks and tough times where you must force yourself through them, but you cannot do that throughout the whole journey. So the first thing you need is to pick something that you really want to make and play. Question number 2, is there a market for your game? Once you've decided a specific game you want to make, you have to ask yourself if there are enough people out there who share your interests. You can look at Steam Spy to get an overview of what games sell in what genres. Be honest with yourself about what the size of the market actually is. So for example, don't tell yourself that your adventure game will somehow appeal to Counter-Strike players. Question number 3. Are there similar games that have achieved enough success? This is very much linked to the previous question. Once you've decided that there are people who would be interested, it's time to see if the numbers match up. Success in here is relative. For example, the market for point and clicks is much, much smaller than the market for multiplayer first-person shooters. So you can see why the big publishers chased that genre instead of making point and clicks. It's the only way to get a return on their investment of hundreds of millions of dollars. However, if you're working on a simple game by yourself or with a small team, then maybe the market for point and clicks is enough. If your definition of success is 10,000 copies, you have more options than if you require 100,000 copies to make a profit. So look at your desired genre and go through Steam Spy to see how games of a similar level of quality can sell. You need to be brutally honest with yourself. Don't just look at the top seller and tell yourself you'll be fine. For example, if you're making an action platformer, don't look at Dead Cells as proof that it's easy to sell a million copies. Instead, look for more reasonable examples. Question number 4. Is your idea unique enough to stand out? This is a tough one since it's very much a balancing act. You need to be unique enough to stand out, but not too unique that ends up just confusing your target audience. Making a straight clone is great as a learning experience, but it won't find much success. Especially if you don't have a large marketing budget, you need to have something that quickly hooks potential players. The amount of uniqueness you need is also relative to the genre you have chosen. There are thousands of platformers, so it takes something extremely special to truly stand out. The other side of that is you don't need to be as unique if you're in a less crowded genre since there's less competition. So ask yourself, if you saw an image or a short 5-second clip of your game in action, would it grab you? Or would you dismiss it as just another game? Question number 5. Can you make it? This might sound obvious, but still is something you need to ask yourself. There certainly is a market for an open-world sci-fi RPG, but could you actually pull it off? This will naturally depend on the size of your team and your skill level. If you're working alone or with just one other person, you have to be very careful about the scope you plan for. So once you have a rough idea of what you'd like to do, create a small prototype that contains the essential elements for your game. If you think your game will require some really special AI code or some very fancy shader effects, then make sure you quickly see if it can actually be done before you spend too much time and realize you don't yet have the necessary skills to bring your vision to life. So there you have it, 5 questions to ask yourself when deciding what your next game will be. The more you think about your answers, the better your final choice will be. If you have any questions, post them in the comments and I'll do my best to answer them. Subscribe for more videos and I'll see you next time.